Hey guys, I'm Josh and welcome to my channel Video Epo, and in this video we are going to make a windmill. I do not limit my interest to anything in particular, so I've done a lot of random things in the past. Please have a look and we'll get back to the video right after the intro. Welcome back guys, I'm going to make a windmill. Yes, but if you're watching this video to make a windmill that will power your house or charge your batteries, I'm sure this video is not for you. You can skip this video right now. But let me tell you what I think. Whenever I have something big in mind, like a big project in my head, I would break it down into smaller, manageable steps, and this video is one such step. So I'm sure there'll be something interesting for you to watch, and therefore I request you to watch this video from start to end. So I'll show you what I've got on my workbench here. What I have here is a couple of pulleys, and these pulleys are driven pulleys which are attached to a motor in the wet grinder. Now this model has got a bushing which is going to hold the shaft, and the shaft is held by grub screws. The shaft also is attached to a ball bearing, and then it works that way. But the other model that I have, the shaft, the ball bearing, everything is enclosed in one piece and it's got a base attached to it. And this one seems to be ideal for this project because I think it solves a lot of other steps that we will have to do otherwise. Just for the information, I've got another pulley here which is made of metal, and this is from a washing machine. And this has got a little bit of an awkward shape, and it is going to be a little bit difficult to attach the turbine blades. So just for the information, I'm saying this. So I will be using this model for this project. In most of the DIY windmill making videos, you will find people cutting PVC pipes and making turbine blades. This small piece, about 2 feet, costed me around 500 rupees. So I've got another solution for this, making it cost effective. I found fan blades, and this is from the flea market. They sell it in sets of threes, and each set has costed me around 100 rupees. So I've got two of these sets, and that's because the model I'm going to use now is going to need four of these blades. So I'll have to borrow one from this set. So I've got four, and it's making it cost effective, and it can reduce the hassle of cutting all these blades to shape. The next important component to enable the windmill to produce electricity would be to use a generator motor. I've got one small little motor here. This is the best from my collection. There are better models available out there, but I will order one of those once the shipment resumes and this lockdown is over. So for this project, I think this should be able to do the job. These thin aluminium strips will be the connectors that will connect the pulley with bolts and the fan blades. And I'm deliberately leaving a little bit of a gap here. I'm not resting this on the pulley. That is because if I were to tilt the angle of the blades to optimize it, I need some space, and therefore having a little bit of a space between the pulley and the blade is going to help us later. The connectors already present on the fan blade. Sometimes they are held together by screws, but this one is held by rivets. If it was held by screws, this wouldn't be a problem. I could have removed it, but now this model has got rivets. Also, it has got a little bit of a bend to it, so that it creates that aerodynamic shape, and it displaces air. But this is going to be a problem for us, so I will have to straighten this out. There are better ways to make matching holes, but this is a quick fix. Since the bend on the fan blade has been straightened, these connectors will have to be twisted to make the blades aerodynamic. Without this twist, the efficiency of the turbines would drop by a large percentage. I've attached the motor to a block of wood, and it is held with a rubber strip from a bike tube. Let me quickly explain to you what I've done here. This is the pulley that I showed you earlier, and it had some base as a single piece, and I took two blocks of wood, attached them to a 90 degree angle,
and I mounted the pulley onto that base. In order to mount the motor somewhere closer, I was actually thinking of driving it through a belt, but then I decided to attach it directly. So what I did is I attached a small block of wood and added a hinge so that it will have this kind of a movement, and the tension is held together by using a piece of rubber band. So there it goes. Now it's got enough tension, so you know it should work.
There are engineering reasons for the windmill to have only three blades. Two blades cause a phenomenon called as gyroscopic precession, and more than three blades cause more wind resistance, dropping the efficiency of the turbine. For this project, however, I am going with four blades only to keep the project simple. The stand for holding the turbine is made from slotted angle iron. These can be put together with nuts and bolts, which kind of avoids the hassle of welding. We can always dismantle and reuse it. It's like the mechanic's toy for hobbyists. So the turbine setup I made is simply clamped to the stand with strong C-clamps. A small load of USB light was attached to the motor. The output from the motor is alternating current. It is not rectified with the full bridge rectifier yet, and this bulb is only using half cycle of the charge to light up when I try to rotate it by hand.
You can see that the leaves of the trees are not moving at all, which means there is no wind. So it happens once in a while. And there is a little bit of a balancing issue with the blades.
I tried to tweak the turbine blade and made a few adjustments to optimize the rotation of the turbine. Now I need to take the windmill to some place where there is wind. And little Tim is already waiting at the location holding a multimeter. They say you got to carry your own cross. In this case, it is mounted on a stand and it is rotating. This design doesn't have a yaw, and I need to turn it to the direction of the wind manually. This is my high-tech idea to check the direction of the wind, and it seems to work.
That's my son Tedu. Say hi, Tedu. Hi. That's making about more than 50 milliamps. That's impressive. Let's see how much voltage it's making. Somewhere around 4 or 5, maybe.
I could stop here and tell you that this project is a success. I've made a windmill that produces electricity, but I'll be wrong. This project it works good as a exhibition project or a school project or a, you know, for a college project, because most of the time what you guys do is attach a motor to a fan blade and then you tell that it's a windmill. But this one will definitely produce some sort of electricity, maybe less, but it will definitely produce something. And you can always have some kind of electronics that can rectify the AC current into DC and power small appliances. But to put it to a practical use, I don't think it's going to work. So as a windmill project, yes, it's a working model, but will it solve the problem of your electricity? I don't think so.
There are a few important points to summarize before we wrap up this video. After the first test, I thought of giving up on the idea of making a functional windmill, but I pressed hard, I made some changes, made some tweaks, then I carried this windmill to an elevated spot. The windmill was set up at a place just about the same height of my terrace because my house is on a hill, and I carried the windmill further up the hill. What I've observed is that the wind is not very consistent, but the windmill has enough torque with a good flow of wind. One thing that most people fail to mention is the importance of geography when installing a windmill. The windmill should be installed in a place where there are no obstacles like trees or buildings. DIY or factory made one, it doesn't really matter. You need to be mindful about these things when you're investing in a rooftop windmill. The next point is, in a DIY project like this, if I could make the blades a little bit longer and wider and adding a yaw to rotate the turbine with respect to the direction of the wind, it should be able to maximize the efficiency of the turbine. And as for the generator slash motor, I need to find a better one. And if you know of any such model, please let me know in the comment section below, and let's hope that it fits in the budget. You see, most of the parts that I've used in the project are either salvaged or recycled. This was a test project, guys, and it works. I'm listing all possible improvements, the insight, the mistakes, everything down below in the description, including the disclaimer. I hope you like this video, and if you do, please share it with your friends or share it with anybody who could benefit from it. Guys, you can click on the video on top to see another interesting build like this, and the bottom video is what YouTube feels is good on my channel. You can always click on my channel logo to subscribe to my channel, and while you're at it, please click on the bell and the notifications icon as well so that you can receive notifications on whenever I upload new videos. Appreciate your patience, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Until then, bye.